developments. Now, after removing the errors and warnings from your assembly program, now next work is to debug. Nothing but we need to check the your program working correctly or not. To debug, you have to go to menu bar, debug, click on debug, and click on start or stop debug session. So click on it. So it will switch to the debug mode. So before it showing, sir, because you are working in evaluation mode, which is work up to maximum of 32 kilobyte. So click on OK. And switch to the debug mode. Now on the, you can carefully observe that the left side window, which is project palette, which is replaced by resistor window, and the middle one is replaced by as the editor window, and the top one disassembly window, nothing but the, it will convert your the instruction into the equivalent hexadecimal value, that is disassembly. Then bottom one is command window, and the right one is a stack window or local variables. So you can keep the add the variables as you are not using any data. So that's no need of this call stack plus locals. But our most of our result is we are going to verify from the register window. You can observe that in register window, how registers from R0 to R15 along with the CPSR and SPSR. Okay. But our observation is more over on the R0 to CPSR. CPSR will update when if you are using the instruction with the postfix of yes. So like instead of using add, if you write add yes, it will update the CPSR. Otherwise, it will not update the CPSR. Okay. Now, I'll debug it to need to execute the program step by step. Instead of directly run the program, better it's step by step execution. So, how to do step by step execution? Again, go to debug. You can use the step or directly can run the cursor trial. Or directly can run also by pressing the F5. Better go for step by step, F11. So you can also use the here buttons are there, step over, then run. Okay. Better go for step. You can carefully observe that one advantage. Before execution, all register contents are almost zero except CPSR is D3. Nothing but it is in the user mode. So now I'll execute the first line of the program. Click on the step. You can observe that R get copied, the 5 is copied to the R. You can carefully observe here, R1 is now 5. Similarly, again I press the step. Now R2 become 3. Now next one, add. So add these two. Now you can observe that in content of R, 3 is 8. So 5 plus 3 is 8. Simple addition. Again you press on next step. So you go to the B here. So nothing but you keep the execution in the same state. Reason for that, you should if you fail to add this B branch, then program counter goes in infinite loop. You keep on starting executing some garbage instructions. It will not stop it. So that's why. So we'll add it here, the branch here. Okay. So now our work is to verify your result. So nothing but to write the result, you have to write before execution what are the contents of register R1, R2, R3 or which are register you are used in your program. Then you have to write after execution what the content of after execution. R1 is now 5, R2 is 3, R3 is 8 or any other register you are using it. So in the programming, so you can use R0 to R12. So you can't use R3, R14 and R15. But you can use as we are not working with any sub-program related, so you can use R13 and R14. So better preferably keep the use the registers from R0 to R2. Okay. After writing all the result, then to stop the debug mode. So again go back to debug and click on start or stop debug session. So it will stop the debug. So it will come out from the debug mode back to the project mode. Okay. So these are the steps for execution steps for the assembly program. Okay. So next video I'll demonstrate on the execution of C program. Okay. Thank you.